YouTube fam, it's your girl Leah back again with another video. In today's video, as you can see from the title, we're going to be talking about digital planning. Now, I made a video on my 2022 planners of choice, Black owned, and I talked a little bit about how I myself am getting into digital planning this year. I got into it late 2021 and now I love it, and I'm never going back to solely a paper and pen lifestyle. I cannot do it. But I wanted to give you guys a basic overview of how I use my digital planner, my actual planner is, how I shop for my actual planner, and kind of some of the basic functions, because it can be pretty confusing. I'm gonna say, even if you watch this video, you get into digital planning, it's still going to be a learning curve when it comes to digital planning. It's just very different. If you take notes on your Apple devices, you take notes on these, then maybe this isn't new to you. You're like, oh, I take my notes all the time with GoodNote. I do all this. So you're used to it. If you're not somebody who uses your iPad in that arena, then yeah, it's going to be a little bit of a curve. But I think with today's video, you'll be able to swimmingly get through said learning curve at least a beginner level. Now, first, I'm going to say this is coming from an Apple user. I am a heavy Apple user, been team Apple since 2012, so 10 years of nonstop Apple use. So I'm not that familiar with anything Android related. I'm not used to anything Android related. I only know the Apple iOS systems. So I unfortunately cannot tell you how the interface digital planning would go on like a Windows Surface or any kind of Samsung tablets. All I know is the iPad and digital planning on this way. So unfortunately, that's what today's video is going to focus on. First, going into how I picked my digital planner. So first things first, what you need to do is decide what app you want to utilize for digital planning. You need to get the app before you actually buy the planner itself. The app that is largely used is GoodNote. GoodNote's 5 paid application. I believe it's $12 in the Apple store. And I just read reviews on it. Everyone said that is the app that is premier. Now they do have other apps. I believe there's 2 other ones that I've seen reference other places. Not as great, I've heard, but I went with GoodNotes. GoodNotes is the app I use, but then you need to pick a planner. You can get a planner, a digital planning from so many other companies. Companies offer them now. I think Passion Planner has a now digital planner that you can use with GoodNotes. You can do that, but what I did was I surfed Etsy. I love Etsy for regular life things, so I searched Etsy for a digital planner, and I'm gonna switch over now into my viewing so you can see what I'm seeing on my screen. So the first thing I did was I logged onto Etsy and I wanted a planner that was a 2021 at that time, because we were in last year, although my planner ended up being a 2022 planner as well. I went and got a 2022, so looking up on Etsy, a digital planner, and so many come up. And looking back at my Start planner, which is one of my favorite planners that I've ever gotten, and I wanted a similar planner. I wanted a planner that was going to mirror my Start planner in the sense that I wanted the same features. I went with the Start planner and I bought my Start planner because it had things such as the dated times on the side. I love the fact that my Start planner had daily tasks. I like the fact that it had I didn't utilize it a lot back then, but a water tracker, a food tracker, a top 3 of every day. I wanted a planner that looked like my Start planner in digital form. That's exactly what I wanted, and so that's exactly what I searched Etsy for. I went and looked at many a planner, and they have so many. Again, I got a lot of questions in my last morning routine video to link my specific planner that I had, and I did it, but I want you guys to know planning is something that's so personal and so unique to each person that the planner that works for me might not be the planner that works for you, and that's totally fine. Etsy has so many digital planning options. It's not funny. I went through so many and looked at so many to figure out what exactly I wanted, and I landed on the planner that I have, which is this one right here, and it is the all-in-one daily planner. Now, this one was a combined 2021 and 2022 at the time time I purchased it right now, it looks like it even has a 2023 aspect to it. So I should have maybe waited a couple of moments and I could have got a 3-year planner for the price of $1,284. So this is the one I purchased, but this seller, again, if you look at all the features of it, they give you several options. She gives you certain weekly layouts. Before I purchased, I made sure that everything looked like how I wanted to look. But if you go to her actual page, so I'm going to open up her page right now on Etsy, she sells the same planner in different styles. So again, mine is a certain color. If you want a darker one, if you want a dusty pink, if you want it winter themed, neutral themed, if you want any of these looks and any of these features, she has them for you. So if you want just a blush version of the one I have, then you get the blush version of the one I have. I will link the one I have down below, but I'm always like, just you don't have to do exactly the one I have, you guys. If you want to open yourself up, please explore other options. I love my planner. It says it was featured on CNN, which I didn't even know they had a feature for that, but I looked at everything and examined everything before I purchased. Again, they're relatively affordable. Most planners, digital planners, are. And this one, again, was made for GoodNotes. So you see, it's a GoodNotes planner specifically. If you use another software or you buy another app, then you're going to need an app that is for your specific one. But this was for GoodNotes, so that worked perfectly for me. And then I purchased it. So when I purchased it, it was an instant download, so I didn't have to wait. It came to my email and I got to actually customize it. I'm sorry, I haven't even opened it. I have my 2021 right here, and then I have my 2022 right here. Those are the two that I purchased from my app, and those are what they look like, but I customize it. So if you see what a day of mine looks like, and let me go specifically to a day. So December or January 7th, this is what my layout looks like, but I chose this specific layout. So when you get your planner and then you get the digital file, this is what you download. So this is what I downloaded and what I saw when I got my planner. And I was like, what is this? Again, very confusing, but once I got it, I got it. So to start, I click choose my planner. So it took me to this. What year of a planner was I creating? I created my 2021 first while we were still in 2021, and I created my 2022 now that we're transitioning to 2022. So clicking, and now that it's 2023 on their site, I'm sure that the new document has 2023 on there. So I'm going to choose my 2022 document. What kind of start do I want? And you guys know this is important for me. I love a Sunday start calendar and I like this planner. Again, one of the many reasons I chose it was because I wanted to choose my specific start. I love a Sunday start, so I'm gonna go with a Sunday start. That's what I chose, that's what I have. Now, the next thing I got to choose was how I wanted my weekly layout to look. I wasn't too caring about this. I didn't care specifically what my weekly layout looked like because I more so use my daily and my monthly views. But if this is something that you care about, you can create and customize what your weeklies look like. And so I, you know, just going to choose a random one. I'm going to choose my option 3. So I'm going to choose that. And then you get to choose what your actual daily looks like. So this is where I had fun with it. So zooming in, you have option 1 that looks like what mine looks like. That's what I went with, which is a balanced layout, which has the days, it has the task, it has the breakfast, it has all that. But you can use a productive layout where it still has the times, it has the tasks, but on the right side, it has more grids, it has more boxes. And then you have option 3, which is kind of a journaling layout. So you have the task on the left like mine. You have the daily time slots. You have all of that. But you have a whole page of journaling. And then you have a canvas layout. So nothing. You create everything on every single day. Now, I wanted the balance layout, so I chose the balance layout. So it says everything right here. Do you want the 2022 planner with a Sunday weekly start with vertical box layout and a balanced daily layout? That's what I wanted. And so I downloaded my planner. And so open it in a new link, download it. When I open the download, this is my planner. Where do I want to export it? I want to put it into GoodNotes. So GoodNotes. I want to import it as a new document, and I'm going to put it in my documents folder, and I'm going to import this new planner into my documents folder. And that's it. It's that simple. And now I have my planner. So those are the two that I already made. This is the new one that I just made. Mirrors my exact same planner that I have now. But this is kind of the finance tracker. It has monthly trackers. It has weekly trackers. And then when it's not in written form or when it's not in editing form, which it isn't right now, you click the top right if you want to change it to where you want to write in it. Or you click it right now where you don't want to write in it, which makes you be able to toggle between, you know, the sides. So February, March, click on the specific thing, click on the day and it'll take you to the day, click on the month and it'll take you to the month. You slide through. If I were in written view, then it would start writing on the page instead of toggling through the page. And that's not what you want. So, and it wouldn't let me type on it. It would make me write on it. And that's not what I want. So I want to be in toggle view. And so this is what I love. I love having a top three. I love having the task. I love having it. It mirrors my start planner immensely, which is why I went with this planner over my start planner. That is how you create one using the vendor I went with. Again, I've actually bought two. I bought two planners. The second planner that I bought, because I was like, well, what if I don't like that one? This was the second planner that I bought and wasn't bad. It just didn't look the way I wanted it to look. So this is what the days look like on this one, the months and everything. It just wasn't the planner that I have now, which I really like. So you again can buy different planners. Also, you can customize the covers on these things. So any of the covers, you can download and make your cover the way you want to make your cover. So you download your cover, you can download a sticker book that they give you. There's so much that you can download with the vendor I have. I was in my 2021 planner, but now that we are out of that, we are now in my 2022 planner. So this is, again, I'm in toggle view. This is what January looks like overall. I'm still in the process, because I'm filming this the end of December, I'm still in the process of working out what else I'm going to post, but I use this primarily for content creating, and then my dailies I use for content creating and my full-time job. Now the thing about this is that it does not interface with your actual Outlook or your Gmail or whatever devices that you want it to interact with. So for example, if you're like, well, I want this to send me reminders, you're going to actually have to transfer it to your Gmail or your Outlook or your Yahoo Mail. This is a separate thing. It's just basically taking your planner, your written planner, and putting it in a digital form. It's not linking. There might be a way it can link, but mine currently does not link with anything else. So if I want to go to a specific day, I just click again right here, and then I start working through it. Now again, having to toggle now into written form, and I don't want to use a yellow highlighter, I want to use a pen and write in black. I just go to black and then say, hey, when I wake up in the morning, I want to have breakfast. I do not write like this in a normal day. That's why most of the time I use type. So if you see a lot more typing, I type my stuff because I still want it to look good and not my crappy handwriting. I will put that in there. Or if I have a meeting, you know, I can actually write meeting. Again, I have terrible handwriting, which is why I do that. Or if I want to use the text box, but I still want to write, I can do that as well. So I can still do that and it will translate to the actual. And so I can do that. And if I want to blow it up and make it bigger, then I can do that as well. Another thing, I love stickers. I actually bought a lot of stickers from Etsy. There's a lot of shops on Etsy that sell stickers. So many sticker shops that sell digital GoodNote stickers. Again, you want to buy a stickers pack that is identical to the actual one you're using. So if you have GoodNotes, you need GoodNote stickers to be able to kind of correlate in that way. Sometimes I just edit and share by copying, and then I will go ahead and paste my stickers there. So if it's pizza night, just remind myself, hey, it's pizza night, so put that there. I'm a good big sticker fan. I love a good sticker, and I love using my stickers in fun and creative ways to make my planner again pop and just stand out more. So this is an example of what a day might look like that's a little more chill. I was wiping through to see if I could find like a work day. But every single work day, unfortunately, I put Canvas names in my planner. So I had people's full names on this way, and I can't show you what a typical Monday through Friday looks like for me. But a Sunday might include editing a video, filming a video. I might put my stickers down. I might put my little thing down. I didn't have a lot of tasks on this day. Typically, my work days have a lot more tasks than my weekend days. Two important things I wanted to highlight is, one, I use the paper-like filter over my screen as my screen protectant. It feels like you're writing on paper. I bought this screen protector as soon as I bought my iPad, so I've never written on it without using this protector. It feels very much so like you're writing on paper, which is amazing if you want to use your planner for note-taking and things of that nature. Another thing, the planner will sync with your other ISO devices. So it syncs with my phone. I have the GoodNotes planner on my phone as well. So anytime I make changes on my iPad, it automatically syncs up with my phone as well. So if I'm on the go and I don't want to bring it with me, that's perfectly fine. I can just look at my phone and everything that was written on my actual iPad planner is on my phone as well. It just, of course, with the cloud, everything syncs up beautifully. So that's it for me. That is digital planning. That is how I digital plan on a macro level, on a larger scale, without drilling too deep into the details. If it helps you out in any capacity, let me know down below. Do you think you're going to get into planning in 2022? Is that something that you're looking to get into? Is digital planning for you? I think it would be. Even if you feel like I'm not that technically savvy, I think it's so much more easier to carry around this, which I always carry around anyways. I edit all my videos on this. I watch TV, I watch shows, I watch YouTube videos. I watch a lot on this. This is like a lifeline with me. It feels so much greater to not have to have this and then a chunky planner on top of this. This is the planner. I close this up and I have my life in my hands right now. But I hope this video was helpful for you. If it was, give it a big thumbs up. Even if it wasn't, still give it a big thumbs up. We want all the love and support over here on this channel. We also want you to subscribe. We want you to become part of the family. And we want you to follow us on Instagram at LeahLamont89 so you can watch and keep up with my shenanigans in real time. And I'll see you in my next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye. No. Bad man. Yeah, yeah.